Hey everybody, thanks for stopping by our channel. My name is Alan Leistekill and I am the youth pastor for Core Student Ministries. I am so honored and thankful that you have checked out our YouTube channel, because here at Core Student Ministries, we are deeply passionate about creating digital content that helps you stay connected to your church, to your youth group, and most importantly, to Jesus. And if you could do me a quick favor, can you hit the subscribe button for us down below? Can you also click that little bell icon so that you can be notified every time we upload a video and every time we go live for Wednesday night youth worship? And lastly, can you put a comment down below and just letting us know how we can pray for you, because we care deeply and passionately about your faith journey and your spiritual well-being. Now let's jump over to our video for today. Now that we put our phones in the basket, let's get our hands ready. We're going to go into a time of worship. We're going to do two songs. We're going to have a message with a lot of really fun games, and we're going to end on two more songs. So get your hands ready. And as one family, we're going to clap together on the count of three. One, two, three. Let's do that again. All right. One, two, three. Heavenly Father, I want to thank you so much for tonight. I want to thank you for the opportunity to worship you, to be in this space, to eat pizza, to hang out with our friends, to get away from school, to get away from homework, to get away from stress. And God, there are things in our hearts right now, there are things in our minds, things in our lives that are distracting us, that are keeping us separated from you. Give us the strength to put that at the door so that as we worship tonight, as we celebrate the birth of your son, we can feel your presence. And we can experience something brand new. We can feel that unconditional, that everlasting, that forever love that you have for us. And even though it's online, even though it's up on a screen, God, it is still worship, and we are going to cry out to you with everything we have. In the name of your son, Jesus Christ, we pray. Amen. All right, so let's go ahead and stand on up. Let's turn the lights off for me. And Luke, you got it under control? Perfect. Let's turn the stage lights off, too.
If I can make the whole church clap, but ain't a clap in the heavens, then that clap. just a clap, clap. Holy Spirit glorified, seen mortified. The Holy Spirit with going word that truth ain't more than that. It sound doctrine, it's birthing and coming out. Let them all sing it loud, but that ain't where the power's at. On the church, church has been clapping at weak sermons. Leaving the weak hurt, no one's changed by Sunday service. We need discernment, check what you be affirming. Cause the church can be full of members, but empty in conversion.
This house, we welcome the dynamic.
Come set your rule and reign in our hearts again. Increase in us, we pray. Unveil why we're made. Come set our hearts ablaze with hope like wildfire in church. We need your power in us. We seek your kingdom first. We hunger and we thirst. Refuse to waste our lives. For you are our joy and prize. To see the captive hearts released. The hurt, the sick, the poor. Church, we pray, revive this earth.
Build your kingdom here. Let the
go ahead and have a seat for me. We'll have two more songs here in a little while. We'll have two more songs in just a wee bit. All right, can we get some lights back on for me? I can't see. I'm in darkness. I cannot see. You like that song? Yeah, that's a good song. That's a real good song. Hey, Luke, can we play our intro video real quick? Welcome back to Merry Christmas to me. Well, not to you guys, but to me. And so tonight, we're going to start off with a fun little game. I have a quick question, though. Have you ever opened up a Christmas present from maybe a friend or a family member that was just absolutely terrible, but you had to act like it was awesome because they were right there in front of you? Has that ever happened to you guys? Has that actually happened to me? Well, I'm glad it's happened only to a few of you guys, but since that could actually happen this Christmas, I thought we'd play a game kind of designed to get you ready to brag about really terrible gifts. So I want to invite our two college interns, Caleb Evans and Charlie Fowler, to come forward for me. So each of them, this is for you. And this is for you. And so what they're going to do, they're going to take turns doing this. They have five gifts in each of these bags. Now, they're horrible, horrible gifts, gifts they would never want, but they're going to act like they do. And as they act like they enjoy their Christmas gift, they are going to describe it. And then you are going to have to guess what it is. All right? They each have five gifts, and when Caleb's going, the guys will guess, and then when Charlie is going, the girls will guess, all right? They will. It's on a piece of paper. It's not an actual present in it. It's just a piece of paper. So, ladies, you are going to go first. So pull your first present. You got to be super excited. No. And now you have to describe it to the girls. Uh-oh.
There it goes, girl.
So she finally gets it, but I'll be honest, the fact that she doesn't get it really makes me nervous. But, Charlie, give it your best shot.
Oh my god, I can't
So it goes click, 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 and then you tighten it, click, 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 and then you... No, no, nope, 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 close, close. Hey, hey, Charlie. Paige said it right here. What is it? A ratchet set, good job. All right, gentlemen, now it is the boys' turn. What? All right, listen to Caleb.
All
Wow, you guys really don't know your Christmas gifts. But I did tell you they were going to be terrible gifts. All right, ladies. It was a football. All right, gentlemen, pay attention to Caleb.
Every man needs to go take a day off at the spa and give one of these bad boys.
Keep on.
A little
sign. Yeah, maybe.
Good job. All right, ladies.
Hey, Caleb.
No. Is there anybody famous who wears one? No. But you're close. It is a hat.
I thought this was
Luke's figured it out. But Luke, oh, because Luke has the answers. I think you should probably all turn back and look at Luke.
Yeah.
Luke!
Oh, wait.
Oh, man, Luke, put it back on. Huh? Well, there's no points. There's no winner or loser. Yeah, good job! All right, gentlemen, listen to Caleb.
Okay, so it's something my grandma was getting, I'd be so hyped to get it.
That's a sweater.
These northerners, they don't really know, they don't have their yes man to no man's now. It's a book.
Oh my goodness.
It is common sense. We appreciate the common sense. But you had it, Matthew.
Close.
It has nothing to do with manners. It's a book on manners.
There you go. Book on manners. Yeah, close enough. All right, ladies.
Oh my goodness.
You're close. Yeah, that's good enough. The top 20 all-time touchdown DVD.
How is anybody supposed to guess that?
Not supposed to. But it's not about guessing. It's about how bad the gift is for the person receiving it.
You didn't ask me that mystery thing?
Oh, yeah. All right, gentlemen, listen to Caleb.
Okay. First of all, she's a good one, all right? She sings all the music for bangers. And it's a recent album out. Oh, which one? Which album? Say which one? Which album? Bro, no.
You know who it is. You just don't know what album it is. It is Natalie's favorite. It just came out.
Bro, y'all
You wouldn't have known it. That's true. All right, ladies. Yes, there you go. Good job.
Folklore.
Good job. All right, last one, ladies. Folklore. There you go. Now here's why the makeup one was really bad, because it's that little tiny practice kit that like a little girl gets from the dollar store. Yeah. That's why it's really bad, because you guys don't want that. Some do. All right, boys, last one.
All right, so whenever I went to college, like, everyone was giving me this, and I still haven't run out of it yet. Every time I'm over there cleaning stuff.
Close.
You know, remember that challenge where, like, everyone almost killed themselves?
Oh, my God.
Yeah, of
Let's give it a round of applause for our awesome interns. Hey, Kyle. Our live stream's not working. Oh, all right. Uno momento, por favor. So, over the top right corner, hit media, hit that blue box. There you go. Yeah, who was this? Ah, well, so we're gonna move forward right along. You know, the truth is, for the people who were receiving those gifts, those wouldn't have been fun gifts. I mean, like, for example, for a bunch of girls, you may not necessarily enjoy getting a 10-piece ratchet set. And for most, well, okay, some would, and most boys wouldn't enjoy getting Folklore by Taylor Swift as a gift. But, or Frozen, I definitely wouldn't want to get. No, some guys actually like mani pedis. Yeah, it's kind of weird. But here's the thing, whether it's an awesome Christmas gift, maybe it's a thoughtful note, or a well-timed hug, if we think hard enough, I think we can recall at least one gift that we are really, really happy to receive. Or maybe it's that one gift that you were really happy to give. You know, maybe this is the one thing that you received that was the top of your list. All right, this is number one on your Christmas list. Maybe it's a gift that was given to you by surprise and you didn't know you needed it until you actually got it. Or maybe you got that perfect gift for your friends or family and you were so excited for them to open it up. So I want to kind of hear from you guys. What has been the very best gift for Christmas that you have ever gotten? Cameron. Your old Nintendo 3DS. Ezekiel. A rifle. Jake. Okay, Micah. Listen, guys. Shh, shh, shh. Mm-hmm. Cool. And you gave that to somebody? Cool. Yes. Okay. Mm-hmm. Nice, good job. Paige, what about you? Your two guinea pigs. Kirsten, what about you? Good for you, nice. Jake, last one. Your grandfather gave you a rifle, that's awesome. Well, since you guys have shared with me your all-time favorite Christmas gift, I want to share with you one that I got. For some of you who don't know this about me, I actually lived in Florida for about 14 years. And the truth is, I absolutely hated it. I hated living in Florida. It was absolutely miserable. And when I was about a junior or a senior, I can't really remember when this happened, but I distinctly remember I didn't want anything for Christmas. I didn't want to have any expectations. I just wanted people just to give me gifts they thought that I would like. And so I can't remember if it was my grandparents or my parents. I was having a real rough time this year, and they decided to get me something that I didn't even know I needed or wanted. They got me this gigantic blanket. You know those blankets that are super soft, like cashmere, and they're really big and you can kind of wrap yourself up in? Well, I got something like that, but what made it really special is that it was a print of the Texas state flag. Because this is my home, this is where I grew up in, and I love Texas. In fact, I tell people all the time that the state flag runs in my veins. That's how much I love this state. And so at a time where I was most sad, when I missed my home, someone just randomly gave me this gift. And honestly, of the 33 years I've lived on this planet, that has been my all-time favorite gift. And the truth is, when we give or receive that perfect gift, it's natural that we want to brag about it. I mean, when we're so filled with joy and excitement, of course, we want to go to the whole world. We want to text our friends. We want to put it on Snapchat and let everybody know about that perfect gift. Well, that's what we're going to be talking about tonight. The perfect gift. Will you guys pray with me? Abba, Father, I want to thank you so much for tonight. Even being here is a gift, Lord. The freedom to be able to worship you, the ability to have snacks and drinks and food and friendship. That is one of the best gifts we could ever receive. But the very best gift that we will ever receive is the salvation that your Son, Jesus Christ, gives all of us, the freedom from sin. And tonight, we just want to say thank you for that. And we just ask that as we go into this time of learning about your Son, that you help us to remember this season is not about gifts, but it's about you. That you loved us so much, that you fought for us, that you sent your only Son to die for us so that we may live. So Lord God, I just pray in the name of your Son that we get to feel your presence tonight. That you take me away so it not be my message, but let it be yours. That your voice echoes in this hall. Amen. Before we dive into God's Word, I want to play another game with you. And this time, there is a reward, and this time, it is a very serious competition. This is your reward. This is going to be a D group competition. Whatever D group wins this competition, we'll get this at the end of the night, or when we go into D group. So I have a question for you guys. Some of you may not have done this before, but by a show of hands, how many of you have ever wrapped a Christmas gift before? Okay, good. Most of you guys have. Well, for those of you who have, this is going to be super easy. Unfortunately, for those of you who have not, this might be a bit of a challenging game. So we're going to have two volunteers from each D group. One person is going to be the gift. Hold on. Just be patient. One person's going to be the Christmas gift. The other person is going to be the Christmas gift wrapper. And what you have to do is you have to wrap this gift perfectly. You have to put the bow on top. And you have to come up with a very clever Christmas tag, because each of you will get a Christmas tag. Then at the very end, all the adults will come forward, they will inspect your gift wrapping, and they will decide which D group has the best Christmas wrappers. So, junior high girls, I need two volunteers. So I'm going to choose. Who do I want to choose? Let's choose Kirsten, and let's choose our new friend. Come on up here with me. Junior high girls, I want you to stand right over here for me. Now, junior high boys, I need two volunteers from junior high boys. Let's get Cameron and Zeke. You two come up for me. You two are going to be right here. Senior high girls, let's do, well, since only three, you know what, let's get all three senior high girls up here. Now, senior high boys. All right, we'll do Jake, and Kyle. All right, yep, all three of you guys, come on up.
See, you actually know how to rap.
What? No. All right. This is your bow. Yes, only one D group wins. That's your bow. And then this is your tag. This is your marker. I don't care. This is your tag. This is your marker. And then this is your tag and your marker. Sure, if you want. It's all up to your team. And then... that is your wrapping paper. This is your wrapping paper. And this is your wrapping paper. You don't have to if you don't want to. You have to do the very best job you can to convince the adults that you rapped perfectly. 1 minute.
Whoa.
1 minute. Yep, 1 minute. Not yet, not yet. Not yet, not yet, not yet. Hold on, hold on. I'll have a 1 minute clock up on the screen for you. Hold on, hold on. No, you can keep going. It is the perfect rap, and the adults are going to decide. Luke, let's go ahead and put 1 minute on the clock. And go.
Begins in 3, 2, 1.
I need all of my adult volunteers to come forward for me. Need all of my adult volunteers. And as a group, you need to evaluate these four gifts. So evaluate them on their wrapping, on their wrapping. Make sure you evaluate their tag as well. Adults, you are evaluating their wrapping skills and their tag. You're evaluating their wrapping and their tag. Now, if I can have my adults, if you've made your decision, go into the very back for me and converse with yourself. Not yet. Not yet. You got 1 minute to make your decision, adults. 1 minute to make your decision. And this is what's on the line for the D groups. So, I think the senior high girls win it! Good job. You guys can have a seat for me. You guys can have a seat for me. You can have a seat for me. All right, have a seat for me. Have a seat for me. Have a seat for me. All right, have a seat for me. Have a seat for me. All right, let's focus. Let's focus. What? Outside. All right, let's focus. So if you happen to have came out last week, you know that we're talking about how easy that it can be for us to focus on ourselves here at Christmas time. You know, we can get so wrapped up, pun intended, and what we want, and what we expect, and what we experience. So sometimes it's difficult to remember what this season is really about. So each week in this series, we're going to hear the stories of people who were present on the very first Christmas, the day that Jesus was born. If you were with us last week, or if you happen to watch the live stream, we saw how Mary and Joseph, the parents of Jesus, gave up their comforts in order to make the very first Christmas happen. You all right?
Yeah.
Okay. But you see, it was uncomfortable. But they chose to join in God's mission. They chose to take on the responsibility of parenting the Savior of the world. Today, we're going to take a look at a whole group of people who played another important part in the first Christmas. Now, here's the truth. We don't really know their names, but this is what we do know. They were given a gift, and they could not help but want to go tell other people. You know, today, our most brag-worthy Christmas presents, it might be a new puppy, maybe those new Yeezys, the next generation console. But did you know that 2,000 years ago, on the very first Christmas, everyone's most brag-worthy Christmas gift was a newborn baby named Jesus? And the first people to tell other people about this gift were a group of shepherds. You know, most nativity sets, they show there were shepherds on the scene of Jesus' birth. But do any of you guys actually know their story? And do you even know why they were there in the first place? Have you ever thought about why God would have chosen them, of all the people in the world, to be present at his birth? So we're going to read from the Gospel of Luke tonight. It's going to be up on the screen as well. We're in chapter 2. We're going to read verses 8 through 16. So listen to God's word. And there were shepherds living out in the fields nearby, keeping watch over their flocks at night. An angel of the Lord appeared to them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were terrified. But the angel said to them, "Do not be afraid. I bring you good news of great joy that will be for all the people. Today in the town of David, a Savior has been born to you. He is Christ the Lord. This will be a sign to you. You will find a baby wrapped in clothes and lying in a manger." Suddenly, a great company of heavenly hosts appeared with the angel, praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to men on whom his favor rests." When the angels had left them and gone into heaven, the shepherds said to one another, "Let's go to Bethlehem and see this thing that has happened, which the Lord has told us about." So they hurried off and found Mary and Joseph and the baby who was lying in the manger. You know, just like Mary and Joseph, these shepherds, they really weren't all that special. I mean, they were just average people. They were working really, really late, and they weren't particularly educated or rich or influential or even important. Yet, that's exactly who God chose to be some of the first people on earth to hear the good news that the Savior of the world had just been born. You know, at first, when this happened, they were terrified. And of course they would be. I would. And honestly, I think we all would be terrified if this mysterious being just showed up in the sky in the middle of the night. But when the angel told the shepherds about Jesus' birth, and a whole group of angels just showed up to sing about it, the shepherds put their fear aside, and they ran to go see what was happening. And you see, the shepherd's role in the very first Christmas, it could have ended right there. You know, they could have run to where baby Jesus had been born. They could have said hi to, you know, Mary and Joseph, his parents, and then just gone home, or maybe gone back to work. They could have kept all this to themselves, but they didn't. In fact, we're going to read this. Listen to this. We're still in the Gospel of Luke, chapter 2. We're not going to read verses 17 through 20, so listen to God's word. Listen to this. When they had seen him, they spread the word concerning what had been told them about this child. And all who heard it were amazed at what the shepherds said to them. But Mary, Jesus' mother, treasured up all these things and pondered them in her heart. The shepherds returned, glorifying and praising God for all the things that they had heard and seen, which were just as they had been told. You know, when the shepherds saw baby Jesus, they absolutely told everyone. And the truth is, if they had social media back then, I'm pretty sure these guys would have figured out how to make hashtag baby Jesus trends. I mean, even the TikTok dances and the TikTok videos would have been absolutely amazing. But since they didn't have phones like you guys do, the shepherds relied on what they did have. You know, they just had their voices. And when they did share what they'd seen, the shepherds didn't make the story about themselves. Instead, they talked about Jesus. And honestly, it really would have been easy for them to think, God chose me to go see the Savior of the world. Well, I must be pretty important. But instead, that's not what they did. Again, the shepherds talked about Jesus. And then the truth is, I am really, really glad that there are a few people in my life who's done the same thing for me as the shepherds had done for others. And I want to tell you three specific stories when this happened to me in my life. The first story was back when I was living in Florida. I think I was a senior, maybe a freshman in college, a senior in high school or a freshman in college. But I was meeting with my senior pastor. His name's Pastor Doug Cox. And I was really battling with some things that young men really, really struggle with. And I'm not going to go into details about it. But it really made me feel gross about myself. And I really hated who I was. So I went and talked to him about it. And the one thing that he told me is that no matter how much I may hate myself, no matter how much I don't love myself or like myself, Jesus will always love me. And that totally changed the way that I viewed myself. And then the second story was actually just a few years ago. Again, for those of you who don't know me very well, I actually went to seminary. I went to graduate school, and I had my master's degree in theological studies. So I study God's word all the time. This is what I do for a profession. Well, Natalie, a few years ago, she talks about how Jesus can be really sassy or how he can be very sarcastic. And I didn't believe her. I mean, I didn't really study that in seminary, and my commentaries never really talked about it. Until I read this one specific commentary where it mentions Jesus actually makes fun of people. And I know that seems kind of mean, but it's for a very specific purpose. But you know what that did? That made Jesus real for me. And it made it real for me because in my family, in the Lystico family, sarcasm is the way that we communicate. So seeing Jesus being sarcastic like my family is just made Jesus all that more real. And then the last story I want to share with you actually happened just this past November, back in 2019. You see, we were raising money to go to Israel for an international mission trip, which we did back in March. But here's the truth. I was really struggling with this. We had to raise close to $40,000 by December. And I had the church fighting me on it and telling me they weren't going to give me money because they didn't want to pay for a vacation, which going on an international mission trip is not a vacation. So I was really, really angry. I was tired. I was worn out. I was having panic attacks, anxiety attacks. And one Sunday, I was actually sitting right there where Cheyenne's sitting. And during the offering, as Natalie is standing up here singing, she's singing a song about the Nicene Creed. And as I'm sitting here praying and I'm wrestling with this, I'm telling God, God, I cannot stand this church. I can't stand this congregation. They're not listening. You told me that we're going to go to Israel, but they're fighting me on it. I am done. I am fed up with this church. And as Natalie's singing this song, the song talks about loving the church because the church is God. It comes from God. And I distinctly remember hearing God tell me in that moment, Alan, how is it that you can love me, but you can't love my church? And in that very same moment, as I'm praying and God is talking to me, someone comes up behind me and puts their hands on me and starts praying over me. Now the song finishes and I end my prayer. I end my conversation with God. And I look back to try to acknowledge who was there to say thank you for what they did because it totally changed the way that I was viewing the church. There was no one there. I kid you not, this really happened. So if you look on the back wall, you'll see security cameras. So I decided to go into our closet to look at the recording from the security cameras. Didn't see anybody. So then later I went to the live stream, couldn't see anybody. The reason I share that story with you is because that person changed my relationship with the church. Again, it made God more real for me. And the truth is, we all love to hear good stories. But the best stories, they do more than just entertain us. The best stories teach us something true. They change who we are. And that's exactly what these three people did for me with their stories and their prayers. And as your youth pastor, this is what I pray every day, so I can do the same thing for you, that my stories can help you change, can help you experience God in a very real way. Because that's also what the shepherds did all those years ago. And on the first Christmas, the greatest gift these shepherds could give to other people was their stories. So I want to challenge you, as we finish out tonight, I want to challenge you with this. Each of you have a remarkable story, an amazing story. How can you share your story with someone else? How can you share what God's doing in your life with someone else to change their lives? Will you pray with me? Abba, Father, I want to thank you so much for every single one of these students. God, I pray that you are changing their lives. I pray that they are able to experience and feel your presence, to feel that love, just like I did. When I was a young teenager or a young adult, when I didn't really like who I was, you still loved me. When I didn't think you spoke a certain way, you did. When I was hurting and struggling the most, you came and you showed up. Father, I pray this over these students, that this happens to them. Maybe not today, maybe not tomorrow, but sometime in this season, during the Christmas season, they can experience that change. They can experience that love. In the name of your Son, Jesus Christ, we pray. Amen. All right, guys, before we go into D group, we have two more songs we're going to sing, and then I will dismiss you. So go ahead and stand on up for me.
You won't give up on me. Your love is all that.
I love you very, very much. I will see you next week for our Christmas party. If you are a 6th grade through 8th grade girl. Hey guys, thanks for checking out our video today. Up on your screen is going to be a link to our channel so that you can go and check out other content that we have created for you. And also there is going to be a link to a video that YouTube thinks that you want to watch next. Now, if that's not the video you want to watch next, again, I highly encourage you to go over to our channel and check out our various playlists that we have, because something in those videos might be what you need right now. Again, thank you so much for checking us out, and we'll see you in the next video. Bye.